Salut à tous, salut, salut, salut à tous. J'espère que vous allez très bien. Alors, c'est encore avec un grand et immense plaisir de me retrouver ici avec vous ce soir. Et donc, pour encore un nouveau numéro, un nouveau direct avec un nouveau problème dont je vais essayer de répondre tout à l'heure. Et donc, vous êtes les bienvenus sur ce direct. Alors, je vous dirai encore un bonsoir et un bonjour à tous et à toutes de part et d'autre depuis votre position où vous me suivez maintenant. Alors, hi everyone, this is your French teacher, Marcel. I'm here again tonight and very happy to be here with you guys. So tonight we have again our live and again a new topic. Just go below this video and you're going to find out our today's topic, which is how to improve your speaking skill in French. All right, so in a few moments, we're going to get started. So I hope, let's give a few more minutes others to join and then we're going to get started in a few moments. So let's everyone get to this live very quick and let's get started. Alors, aujourd'hui, c'est un nouveau numéro, c'est un nouveau direct. Et donc, bonsoir, bonjour à tous. Et donc, vous pouvez laisser vos commentaires et n'oubliez pas d'apporter des soutiens, des likes et tout. Voilà, je suis très heureux. So, if you first time on this live with Professor Marcel, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel to not miss out any interesting video on this channel with Professor Marcel. So everyone is welcome here. So today we're going to have a new live with a new topic, which is just down below on the link on the video. You can see the topic is how to improve your speaking skill in French. That's an interesting and important topic. We need to debate and discuss about it to help others to get more confident and to improve their French speaking, the French language. All right, so in few moments, let's wait a few more people to join this live and let's get started in few moments. All right, so we're gonna start in few moments. Salut à tous, j'espère que vous allez très bien. Alors, c'est encore votre professeur Marcel. Et donc, ce soir, notre thème de ce soir est comment améliorer son niveau de communication en français. Et donc, c'est avec un grand, immense plaisir que je suis là ce soir, maintenant, pour parler, donner mon point de vue, des propositions afin de vous aider à pouvoir améliorer votre niveau de français, et que ce soit en français ou que ce soit en anglais. Et là, le cours sera fait en anglais, par moment en français. Alors, soyez les bienvenus. All right, so we're going to start now. As I said, on our today's topic, we are going to discuss and talk about, give me 1 second, let me just fix this one a little bit. All right, I guess, okay, give me a few more. All right, I think here we are. All right, so as you know, today we're going to discuss about how to improve your speaking skill in French. All right, so when we talk about speaking skill, it's all about, okay, give me 1 second. All right, so here we are. Très bien. All right, now let's get started. All right, so as you know, our topic is how to improve your speaking skill in French. So how to improve? So it means already you have an asset in how to speak French. So it means you have already a background, all right? So first of all, if you want to improve, it means you have already a background. So that background, we have now to give a perfection, we have to give improvement, we have to make it more better, we have to improve, all right? So that's why we are talking about today, how to improve your speaking skill. So first of all, before we start, you need to make sure that you understand today's topic, which is how to improve. So it means, first of all, you are already an asset and you have a background in French. All right. So if you're a beginner, you are intermediate, you are also an advanced learner, you are all welcome here on this to this topic. So it's for everyone, even though you are a beginner, you are intermediate, here you can have more tips and get more solution how you're going to improve your speaking. So if you remember, first of all, we have learned before and discussed how to improve your listening skills, all right, in our previous video. And our latest video, we have discussed about how to improve, all right, or how to start speaking, okay, with a fluent or a native speaker, all right? So how to start. So this was our previous topic, how to start a conversation or communicating with a native or fluent people, all right? And today's topic is how to improve. So now we started to communicate. We started to exchange. We started to talk with a native or fluent people. Now we want to improve, all right? So first of all, in our previous topic, we asked you, okay, I asked you guys to get confidence, all right? So from that topic, I was telling you guys to get confident while you are speaking with native or people who already know the language, all right? So first of all, you need to get confident in order to start speaking, all right? So when you get confident and you need to make sure you always try to speak with your level you are, okay? So if you are a slow learner or whatever is your level, you need now to match up with those who already know, who are fluent or native, by trying to improve with a few vocabulary words, all right? So that's what we're going to talk about today. So how to improve my speaking, as I have already background. I already have an accent. So now how to make it better, how to make it perfect, all right? So first of all, as I know that I have an accent, I know how to speak a little bit, I know how to say something in French, now I want to improve. So what exactly we need to improve, all right? So first of all, when I have a background, so it's me, I have something to improve, all right? So we have something to improve. So before speaking, I know how to speak, I know how to start a conversation, now I want to improve. So what exactly we want to improve? So first of all, you have, maybe some people want to improve maybe their vocabulary, all right? So they know how to speak already, or maybe they know how to, they understand, okay? Some people understand when people speaking French. Oh, I do understand, but I cannot say anything, all right? So it's mean you lack in a vocabulary. You don't have much vocabulary word or expression. All right, so it's mean you have vocabulary word, expression, and all those things to improve, all right? And some people already don't even know how to ask a question, all right? Some people don't even know how to ask questions, all right? So in that way, you need to now learn few things or few expressions and few sentences, all right, to improve and make it better. And some people have a grammar problem. All right, so some having a vocabulary problem, some having grammar problem, some having sentence building problem, some also having the speaking event, all right, and the pronunciation problem, all right. So when you figure out what is your problem, of course you can work on it and just try to improve, all right. Already improvement doesn't come just like that. We need to figure out what we would like to make it better. Hi, everyone. Hope you're doing good. All right. So those who are joining right now, as you can see, we are discussing about how to improve our speaking. All right. So first of all, with your asset, with your background, with your prior knowledge about French, all right, even if you can start the conversation or if you can understand the conversation and you cannot participate, this is your topic and you need to be here and watch this video and listen carefully and try to improve and make it in practice, all right? So let me continue where I stopped right now. So I was saying, whatever is level or what is your background you need to improve. So what we have to improve, so we have to find out and figure out what exactly need to improve, all right? So sometimes we have to improve our vocabulary skill, all right? Some people understand when you say, comment tu vas? Comment ça va? Où vas-tu? Est-ce que tu as bien dormi? Qu'est-ce que tu as mangé aujourd'hui? Tu as accompagné ton frère à l'école? Tu as salué tes parents? Comment va ton boulot? Et tout ça. All right? So sometimes people can understand those sentences. But exactly, they cannot say anything. All right? It means they are lack of vocabulary. They don't have more words or more expression to answer back. All right? So these people need to increase their vocabulary skills. All right. So I already made and explained one video where I was explaining how to improve and increase your vocabulary skill. All right. So this is for those who want to increase the vocabulary skill and they have a few words and few expressions. All right. Then for those who have grammar problem. Okay. How to structure a sentence, how to build up a sentence, and how to make a sentence correct with the tenses, with the grammar, all right? I do understand many people have issue with the French grammar, all right? The French grammar in sense that people say sometimes it's very difficult to identify the genders, why everything has a genders in French. So when they do understand that sometimes they don't want to even try to use some a sentence where we have too much of grammar. Even sometimes with their grammar, they say everything with grammar mistake, grammar pronunciation, all right? J'ai vu une fille, all right? Instead of j'ai vu une fille, this is lack of grammar point, and they don't have proper grammar skills, all right? So they need to work on the grammar, all right? J'ai vu sa chien, all right? J'ai vu sa chien, all right? Which should be j'ai vu son chien, all right? As chien is masculine, all right? Elle va au marché. All right, and instead of saying elle va au marché to a girl, you're going to say il va au marché. These are few grammar mistakes. All right, sometimes people just try do it without realizing it. Okay, this grammar issue and problem also come often with even native or foreign people if they don't discover and learn many words. That's why it's very important to discover and learn the words and the vocabulary. Words and name of things with the genders, that's very important in French language. While learning a new word, a new expression, a new vocabulary word, you need to know and identify what is the gender of that specific word I'm learning, all right? So this is the mouse. In French, it has a gender, all right? Une souris, this is une souris, so it's kind of feminine. So sometimes when you try to explain to people that this is a mouse and this mouse is the feminine as the gender, what? Why a mouse can have and can be feminine, can be lady, can be girl? But actually, I'm not talking about the physical mouse. I'm talking about the word and the noun mouse with the M-O-U-S-N-R-E, all right? So I'm not talking about the mouse physical object, all right? I'm talking about the mouse in the noun, in term of noun, okay? Souris, la souris, or not la souris in a physical object, all right? So this is the confusion and complication sometimes people making while learning words with the French word with the genders, okay? So while learning the genders, please remove from your mind that we are talking about the physical object itself, okay? So I'm saying the laptop, and I'm saying, we say un ordinateur. An ordinateur, so it means it's masculine object, all right? So people sometimes they cannot get, as in English, we have to say a or an, that's easy. We don't have to identify or specify the gender or the number of object. But as I say in my previous video, in French, it's very, very, very important to identify and specify every and single thing you are saying or pointed out in French. That's very important. So if you understand this, that is going to be very easy for you to improve your grammar and your grammar skills and your grammar point. Okay, so while trying to speak, you need to take care, increase your vocabulary, and try to also to improve your grammar. That's very important, okay? While making a sentence, you need to make sure I'm using the right and the appropriate pronoun subject, the appropriate verb, or the appropriate tense, all right? And the appropriate agreement. That's very important while you are speaking French, okay? So that's why I said before starting this live and this explanation, I said before improving is mean you are already a prior knowledge, all right? And now you want to increase, you want to make it better, you want to make it perfect, all right? So while making, I know how to say two. So now I know one, two. Now I want to improve, I want to know more. Now I know I have to learn three, four, five, all right? So I need to learn how to say five, I need to learn how to write five, I need to learn how to pronounce it five. All right, same thing, this is how learning come and improvement come, okay? So while you want to improve, it means you have a prior knowledge, prior asset, background that you want to make it better, all right? So first of all, you have to increase your vocabulary to have many words to say, many things to say, or when you understand. Oh, I understand when people speaking, but I am unable to speak. Yeah, many people saying that sometimes, often we hear, oh, I know French, but actually I cannot speak. It means the person has a vocabulary problem. They don't have a word. They don't have many expressions, all right, to try to improve or say many things, all right? But they can easily understand when people are speaking, but they cannot participate to the conversation, all right? So it means they are blocked, and they will feel that shock, and they will feel that is very annoying and disturbing that they cannot participate to any conversation because of that lack of vocabulary, okay? And that's give very big frustration, all right? So that's why it's very important. If you can understand people speaking a language, which is French, you need now to participate, to push yourself, as I said, how to start in my previous video, all right? So if you know how to start, of course, you will be able to improve, all right, by saying, by improving, all right? So first point, increasing your vocabulary word. Second point, try to improve your grammar. So the grammar point is very huge, and we need to talk more and more about how to improve the grammar point, how to structure a sentence, how to build up a sentence, how is the structure of a sentence, how to ask the question, where to start, why we have the feminine, why we have the masculine, and agreement. It's very important. As in my previous class with my student, I was teaching clothes, how to describe people clothing, all right, or what people wearing, and how to identify a person among many people according to what the person wearing, all right? So in French, in English, it's very easy. The person is wearing a pink, okay, blazer. But in French, we want to know what is the gender of blazer, all right, before telling the color. Because with the color, again, we have agreement, okay, for feminine and for masculine. All right, so for masculine, we say violet. But when it's come for a feminine word or object, we have to say violet. So all these things we need to specify in French. That's very important. Even for the genders, for example. In English, when you go to a classroom, we have students, boys and girls, everyone mixed, all right? So you will say, these students are in the class. So you can easily say, they are in the class. But in French, we say, les élèves sont en classe. So it's mixed. But now we want to know which type of élèves. So when we say, les élèves sont en classe, it means it's mixed, but still it's confused. We don't know if it's only boy student in the class, or only girls in the class, or boys and girls in the class. This in French, we have to specify and make our mind clear who are in the classroom, all right? So first of all, if we say, ils sont en classe. So in our mind, in French, we'll say, these are only boys in the class. Salut, salut à tous, j'espère que vous allez très bien. Alors, j'espère que vous nous prenez en marche et continuez avec nous. All right, so now we want to know who are in the class. So when we say ils sont en classe, it means they are in the class. But actually, il is for male, masculine, boys. All right, but when we use il, it's also combined in a group where boys are. We say il, all right, in the plural, okay? But when we say elles sont en classe, It means in our mind, in French, only ladies or only girls will be in this specific class. All right? So if we say, elles sont en classe, it means only girls are in this class. All right? But if we say, ils sont en classe, it means we have two things coming in our mind. Boys and girls, or only boys. This is in French. So if we say ils sont en classe, we have two things that come to our mind to know who are in the class. So if we say ils sont en classe, it means in the class we have boys and girls. If we say ils sont en classe, it means we have boys and girls in the class, or we have only boys in the class. All right, so this thing, if you understand how it works, already is going to be a very big and great improvement. All right, the genders, it's very important to do that. But in English, it's very easy. They are in the classroom. So we don't want to know who exactly are in the classroom. Boys, girls, boys and girls, or only boys or only girls. But in French, we need to specify and give more detail and precision. All right, so we need to precise who are in the class. So in our mind, everything is clear. So this is French language. French language, we have to make our mind clear. Ils arrivent, they are coming, ils arrivent. So when you hear ils arrivent, it means they are coming. But in our mind, boys and girls are coming. Or only boys are coming, all right? So ils arrivent. So if you hear ils or if you use ils, it means only boys or boys and girls. All right. But if we say elles arrivent, it means only girls are coming. So these are things that when you are beginner or intermediate, if you know and try to understand how it's work, that's perfect. But we can always see people making some mistake, even they are intermediate, still they have this vocabulary problem. Elles arrivent, and still boys and girls coming. And they say elles arrivent, which is wrong. When boys and girls together, always it's il. So as I used to explain and tell to my student, if in a group of boy and they have girls, so 5 girls, 10 girls, many girls, and only one baby boy even in the group, is still masculine. It still is, all right? So this is the problem. I used to explain all the time when I'm teaching the pronoun subject sometime, okay, to the beginners, all right? Always they're asking, sir, if we have a group of girls and boys together, two girls or 5 girls or 10 girls and one boy, are we going to say is or is, all right? So I used to say, if in a group of people, boys and girls, and there is only one even baby boy and 10 girls or ladies or many girls, we still say is, all right? Because of this baby boy, all right, in the group, okay? So we say il for masculine, plural for masculine, they, all right? So we use only el for they, only in a group of female. When there is no single boy even, we say L. So is that clear? That's very big improvement already. And then when it's come, this is for when we're starting, this is a structure of a sentence, okay? Because it's come all the time, people speaking French with all these small mistakes. Because when we are fluent and native and talking with these people, of course, sometimes it gives us some shock when we say elle arrive for boy. It's give a bit shock. And when girl coming and say il arrive, it's give already shock for us, okay? But still we can understand that your learning is maybe this level because you didn't understand that grammar point, or maybe you didn't get proper explanation about how to work on the genders and agreement. That's very important, okay? And also, as I was telling the colors, okay? John is wearing a blue jacket. Or John is wearing a green shirt, all right? So we say, John porte une chemise verte, all right? So vert is green, okay? Vert is green, V-E-R-T, All right, in French, V-E-R-T is green, vert. So we use vert only for masculine object. All right, so we can say, il porte un pantalon vert. All right, so we will say only vert. But if you have to use a feminine cloth, we start with une, okay, like une chemise, okay, une chemise or la chemise. All right, we will say, il porte une chemise verte. Now, V-E-R-T, we have to put now E at the end to make the agreement by, with this E, it means we have a feminine object. So this is how easily you can improve your grammar point. So you need to know agreements, you need to know the genders, you need to know the plural and the masculine form, all right? All these are very important. And you need to know how to do the plural and the singular. This is very important. If you understand, of course, your learning and your improvement is going to be perfect and you're going to improve a lot, all right? So as I was saying, you need to improve many things that you have problem, doubt, or difficulties to make it happen, all right? So some people having a lack of a vocabulary, they don't have enough of vocabulary word. As I was saying, they can understand people talking, speaking, or saying something, but they cannot participate to the conversation much because they have lack of vocabulary. So you need now to improve, and you need to discover many words, you need to learn many new words, then you can easily participate to any conversation, to any debate, to any conversation, all right? And when you have a grammar problem, all right, you need to figure out how to identify, specify, and understand the genders, okay? As I said, you need to understand that in French, every single thing and object has a gender, but not the physical object, all right? Not the physical object. So only the noun or the name of that object has a gender, all right? I was telling this one, mouse, okay? Not the mouse itself, but the noun mouse, okay, has the gender, a mouse, okay? So une souris. So if I say une souris, so it means the mouse is feminine, all right? But not the physical mouse. It means the noun mouse is a feminine. If I say un stylo, it means the pen is masculine. Because we identify those words and noun with une, the article, indefinite article, une, which is feminine, and un, which is masculine, un. So if you see in front of a noun or a word in French, we have un, which is un, it means the noun is masculine. And if you see in front of a noun or word, une, which is une, it means the noun or the word or the object is feminine. All right, so un is masculine, une is feminine. And if you see le, also is masculine. If you say la, is feminine. All right, so feminine, we have une in front of a word, or la in front of a word or noun. And if you see un only in front of a word, it's masculine. If you see also L-E in front of a word, it's also masculine, all right? Sometimes when it's come for L apostrophe, we have sometimes some problem, some people cannot identify easily, all right? So, and some people asking, sir, is there any specific rule to identify any feminine word to a masculine word? Yes, there are, but it's not always right and correct. So we cannot stand with those rules, okay? So you have to learn and easily understand that most of the feminine words have E at the end, okay? Most of the feminine words or agreements, okay, has E at the end, all right? So, but we have some exceptions. So when it's come, we have exception, it means the rule is wrong somewhere. So it means we have now to learn again from the beginning. So if a rule does not have exception, so it means it's a rule. Perfect, we can apply and put it in our mind. But when there are some exceptions, so we cannot give as it is a rule. But we have so many, many rules that we can easily identify many or even 50 or 60 words or noun of feminine noun, okay? So I gave some starting with L-A or U-N-E, une, which are feminine. And most of those feminine words, ending with E. Okay, but there are some exceptions, many exceptions even. When you see UN only and the LE or LE in front of a word or noun, it means it's masculine. Okay, so those who have grammar problems, grammar things, you need to work on those things. All right, so also agreement on possessive adjective. Okay, my. I'm giving some example that you need to understand that this is how it's working in French. Okay, my in French. Okay, when I say my computer, okay, my mouse, my pen. All right, so now you can see my, I'm using for every object in French, in English. But in French, we need to know the gender of the computer, the gender of the mouse, the gender of the pen before applying the appropriate my in French. So in French, we have three, my for feminine, my for masculine, and my for plural. But in English, it's very easy. My computer, my mouse, my pens, all right? My pens, all right? So I'm using even for two pens, I'm using my. For one pen, I'm using my. For computer, I'm using my. For laptop, I'm using my. For mouse, I'm using my. Okay, for everything with no rules, we're using my. So it's very easy. But in French, we have to know what is the gender of computer. So here, computer, we say un ordinateur. So as I explained before, okay, earlier, I said un means masculine. All right, so un ordinateur. So I will say mon ordinateur. Mon ordinateur. All right, une souris. I will say ma souris. Ma souris. M-A. All right, to express my. Okay, mon ordinateur, M-O-N, to see my for masculine object, all right? And mes stylo, M-E-S, all right? Mes stylo. So when it's plural, even it's a masculine object or feminine object, we all say only mes, all right? So it's masculine object, we say mes. If there are many objects, okay? All right, so we say me. If it's feminine object, many, we say me, M-E-S. All right, so we can see here we have mon for masculine object, my, ma for feminine object, my, and me for plural object, many object, two objects. All right, me stylo. All right, so see how it is. So if you understand practically those things, salut, salut, j'espère que vous allez très bien. Oui, salut, j'espère que vous allez très bien. All right, so now we're still explaining on the grammar point, okay? The grammar point, this is how you can understand. If you understand, this is going to be easy for you to understand other things, all right? So this is how easily you can improve, okay? So, and also with the plural, singular and plural, okay? Ils ont un gros chien. They have a big dog, okay? Ils ont... Qu'est-ce que je veux dire? Ils ont une grande télé. Ils ont une grande télé. So they have a big TV. Ils ont une grande télé. All right. So une grande. And ils ont un grand téléphone ou bien un grand ordinateur. All right. Ils ont un grand ordinateur. So here I'm seeing computer because computer is masculine. So I will say un grand ordinateur. Ils ont une grande télé. All right. So you need to specify grand and grande. So grand for masculine. Ils ont un grand. Okay. Un grand ordinateur. Ils ont un grand ordinateur because ordinateur is masculine. Ils ont une grande télé. All right. Because télé is feminine. Now you see grand. For masculine and grande for feminine. So these small details are very important. These small details are very important in French. If you say ils ont une grande télé, oh, that's wrong. Ils ont une grande télé, that's wrong. Ils ont une grande télé, that's right, correct. Okay, we can also see also ils ont un grand ordinateur. Un grand ordinateur. No, it's wrong. Okay, so these are a few mistakes when people are talking and speaking in French. We can easily see that the person has some problem in grammar. So the person needs to improve the grammar skill and the grammar points. All right. So when you are having those grammar point problem, the grammar problem, you need now to perfect it, to learn more and to improve it by looking at what is your problem. You have a sentence structure problem. You have a tense problem. You have gender problem. You have an argument problem. So you have to identify what is the problem you have and then try to work on and make it happen. Try to practice, try to speak it out, try to converse, and then try to make it happen. All right? Because when we carry on with the same mistake of agreement mistake, like ils ont une grande télé. Ah, that's wrong. But if you carry on, ils ont une grande télé, ils ont un grand ordinateur, that's wrong. Okay, you keep going on, you keep going on. Une, it means you don't master properly the genders of word. It means you are learning the word or noun of object without knowing the gender. Okay, so I'm giving you advice. Whenever you're learning a new word, new noun of object, you need to learn with the gender. It's very important. If you take a dictionary, even of a French dictionary, you will say, oh, wait, when they put a noun, they will say it's masculine, it's feminine, it's singular, it's masculine plural, because we have to know the details. We have to specify, understand from where this word coming, how it's structured, which families belongs to, masculine, feminine, plural, starting with vowel, consonant, we have to put E, we have to do agreement. That's very important in French language, all right? So when you understand this concept, that will become very easy and your learning will become better and you will improve very quick and your speaking will be so perfect, all right? And you can converse with anyone perfectly, with confidence, with no mistake, and you can get it done, all right? So you have to look into those aspects and try to heal or improve your problems, okay, different problems you are facing or having while learning French or trying to speak French or even speaking French with a lot of mistakes, a lot of agreement mistakes, a lot of gender mistakes, a lot of those problems. So you need to make sure you are doing the perfect and the appropriate agreement using the proper gender in the sentence. That's very important. All right, that's very good. And also now with the another point to improve is the pronunciation. Okay, is the pronunciation. All right, so sometimes people who already know English or even their mother tongue, like people who speak already German, speaking already Spanish, speaking English, of course, when they are reading or saying something in French, it will always sound like their mother tongue. All right, but what I give as advice to my student, learn a beginner, intermediate, or advanced, I always asking them to read or say that word which sound or which is a little bit similar to English or Spanish or German or Italian or any of the language they already know, to read a bit far from the sound, should be a bit far from what they already know. All right, so like attention. Okay, attention, same spelling in French, but we have to say attention, attention, okay? Attention, give me your attention, intention, all right? So in French, in English, you can say attention, intention, but in French, we have to say attention, intention, all right? So you can see sound completely different, but if you say again intention in French, attention in French, of course, we can see that your pronunciation is not correct and you have to improve that. Okay, so these are different points and small points that people need to understand, identify from what they have as background or what they already have as asset to improve and work on to make it better and perfect on that. All right, so the last point, which was the pronunciation, and try a little bit to pronounce it with the correct one. I can understand because of your mother tongue, because your main language is very difficult to pronounce it as French people or native or how it is in French, okay? But you need to make some effort to pronounce it, even though it's difficult sometimes. Rassemblement. Rassemblement. All right? So some people will be saying rassemblement. Okay? We can understand. Okay? And in French, we can accept it. We can accept it. It doesn't matter. We can understand. As communication, we don't want it to be perfect. But when you want to make it perfect, you need to avoid those unnecessary mistakes, unnecessary headache, because it gives headache sometimes. All right? So, like, rassemblement. Okay? Rassemblement. Rassemblement. Some people will be reading like that. Okay? Recycling. Okay? Recycling. Recyclage. Okay? Sometimes if you want to, they want to read recyclage. Recyclage, all right? So those things need to avoid and try to work on and make it better. How it sounds in French, okay? Recyclage, recyclage, recyclage. Réchauffement climatique, all right? So if also another way to improve, okay? First, I ask you to read and your pronunciation should sound a bit far from your main language or your main mother tongue language that you have, okay? Intention, you know intention in English, so you cannot say again intention in French. So you have to say it a bit, the sound should be a bit far from intention. Intention, try to be a bit far from that sound and you will get the French sound pronunciation. That's one of the best options, the best way, and the best solution to make it work and work on your pronunciation. And second, to make work on your pronunciation, you have sometimes people trying to read quickly. If you, your pronunciation is not perfect and right, please try to go sound by sound, word by word, and you will get it right. All right? You will get it right. Okay? Rassemblement. Okay? So if you can short, 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 you will get the sound and perfect. You will make it a perfect pronunciation. But if you want to go quick, of course, sometimes you will miss out some words, some sound will be missing, resemblement, okay? So some words will be missing, some sound will be missing, which is will make it wrong. So if you cannot say the long words or some complicated sound, just try to carry sharp and small, 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 you'll make it happen and you'll get the right and appropriate sound, all right? So this is how slowly you can make it happen. So when you cut the word sound, I mean sound by sound, of course you will get the pronunciation right and your reading and your pronunciation will be correct. And also, third point to improve your pronunciation, keep listening or listening to people, watching movies, how people saying that in French, how French people saying this in French, how it sounds in French from French native speakers or French or those who are fluent already speaking French, all right? So this is how easily you can improve. If you don't have any friend who is from France or you don't have any native speaker, because only these are the best way to improve your pronunciation. With the native speakers and with people from France, from French country speaking, all right? From French country speaking, so these people, of course, you can make sure reliable that you can easily try to have the perfect and improve your pronunciation, all right? So sometimes some people, even native also need also some time to make it perfect, all right? Because sometimes they're using sometimes some sound because it's native and common. So we can just go quickly without some pronunciation. So sometimes you will not get some things properly. You need to ask, because when we are speaking, we'll be speaking very fast, all right? Very fast. So sometimes you will not be able to get some sound, some word that, oh, so you mean this one? Oh, I didn't understand. Because the person is native and fluent. So the person will be saying something very quick, so you will not be able to get it. And you, oh, so you were talking about recyclage. Recyclage, but maybe you don't know recyclage, or the way the person said is very quick because the person is native speaker. So sometimes you will not be able to get the pronunciation. So that's why it's also important to keep listening to native speakers, to listen to movies, French movies, and all these things. And for those who have opportunity to have French native speakers, that's a very big asset, a very big opportunity for you to improve your speaking skills and to improve your pronunciation as well. Okay, and sentence building structure, everything together, that's a very big opportunity for people in touch with native speakers and being a native country, a French country speaking. That's already a very big improvement. So when some people are also already in a country, French speaking countries, that's also very big. They can easily and quick and fast learn and improve their speaking so quick. All right. So if they have this background, small background with this environment itself, it will make them improve very quick. The speaking, the pronunciation, the articulation, the phonetics, everything will be perfect, but still they will have the mother tongue accent sometime. So this is also sometime easily native speaker, we can identify this person speaking French, but I can see from the accent, I can identify this person is Italian. From the accent, I can identify this person is from Argentina. I can identify this person is from Spain. This person is from maybe India. This person is from, because we can feel and see, understand the accent behind your language and your sound. So this sometimes people want to also improve that. Of course, you can improve by listening and trying to see and understand how native speaker or French speaking people can are saying that specific word, and you can easily try to work on your tone. Bonjour, 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 bonjour. So different tone, different sound, different phonetics. You can work on those things. So these are different aspects that you guys and everyone, beginner, intermediate, advanced, everyone can work on and make it better. So this is all about what I have to say about how to improve your speaking skills. So this is very interesting topic that will have been requested by some student of mine that asked me to try to talk about it. So I hope you guys, it will be helpful for you as well, and it will be helpful, and you're gonna work on that and identify your problem, identify what you have as asset, what you have as background, or what need to work on and to improve to make your speaking better and perfect. All right. So if you identify what exactly need to improve, if you want to improve maybe the way you say words, your pronunciation, your phonetics, your tone, your sound, everything need to improve according to what we found as problem. If you have a problem of how to use word, you can understand people speaking French and you are unable to also participate to the conversation as it should be, you have a problem with vocabulary. You have like and less vocabulary word. This means you have to increase your vocabulary. I did some videos about how to increase your vocabulary word. You can watch and try to have more idea how to make it more and more, how to have more vocabulary word. And also some people can speak, but they cannot be able to understand people speaking. All right, they will always be, can you go slowly? Can you repeat it again? Can you say this again? Oh, can you say it slowly? Then I will understand or get the word right. It means they have also listening problem. Okay, so when you have listening problem, you cannot participate to a debate or conversation or exchanging with people, because conversation, communication coming with exchanging, ask question, answer, asking question, answer, ask question, or talk, reply. So those things only go coming, give, take, give and take, and all those things come to do speaking. So if you can understand and you cannot speak, try to have more vocabulary. If you can speak and you have a difficulty to understand and you don't have, you cannot get properly words when people are speaking, if they are native, fluent, or maybe beginners, and you cannot be able to understand even when you are watching movies, when you are listening to music, you still cannot understand any single word, it means you are listening problem. So it means you have to go slowly with those people or try to ask often, can you repeat again? Can you say it slowly? I will understand. If you're listening to music, you can go slowly or take the lyrics. If you cannot work, please, last option, take the lyrics and try to listen to the lyrics and you would find out the exact word that the singer said in that specific part. Okay, and then you can easily try to, oh, in that part, she was saying, je t'aime, or she was saying, j'ai vu le bonheur, c'était l'étoile. All right, so you can easily understand what exactly was said in the song through the lyrics, if you cannot understand by yourself through just listening. Okay, so while you will do this exercise, you will understand that, oh, this is how they say, this is how it sounds. This is, next time, of course, if somebody is repeating the same sentence or you heard somewhere, easily to come very quick. You don't have to say, could you please repeat again? Or could you please go slowly, because you already know how it sounds, how people said it, and how it is in the sound, in the song, which is maybe faster than when people speak in real life. So all these things need to analyze and identify and try to work on as we wish to perfect our communication skill. All right, so if you are listening problem, yeah, to get people speaking, you have to do those activities to improve your listening skill in order to participate to a conversation, because you know what to say but you didn't listen or get what people said. So it's very difficult for you to participate and to answer. All right, some people also cannot answer, but they can understand. So it means they have very good listening, understanding, that's perfect, but they don't have word to say, the vocabulary is not rich, is poor, less words, less, they don't know many things in many environments, like they don't know how to say many things in maybe traveling, in tourism, in education, in cooking, all right, in restaurant, in many stuff, you have to have vocabulary word to make your learning and your communication talking. As debate, we have to talk about many things, so we need many vocabulary words, all right? So while learning vocabulary words, you need to make sure you're going to use those words in your future to always keep remembering them, as it's gonna be frequent in your speaking, in your mind. So that's how it is. As I said and told in my previous videos, you need to learn things that you are going to use in near future. Then it's going to be very easy for you to keep remembering. But if you learn things that is not in your environment, I'm maybe working in tourism, or maybe in education, and maybe in office, and I don't know how to say many things in my office, many things in education, many things maybe in if I'm petroleum, I need to know many things in petroleum company, petroleum things and all those things, okay? Travel agency, you know, need to know many things in travel agency. Tourism, you need to know many things about it, because this is your daily life, things that you need to practice and say many things in near future that is going to help you to remember, because this is your path. This is your office, your working place, your environment. So if you now know more about your environment, of course, you will try to improve and get more out of your environment. And slowly, your speaking is becoming huge and your communication and vocabulary will be increasing, and you will have more confidence to say many things and be able to communicate with anyone about any topic, everywhere, with anyone. So that's one point that you need to keep in mind and try to work on it very slowly and with confidence as well. And so that's it about our today's topic. I hope I didn't miss out any information to provide you. I hope everyone enjoyed and learned about this live, and also this live, I hope it will be useful and helpful for you guys. So that's it for those who are joining to this live and first time to watch and listen to Monsieur Marcel, Professor Marcel. Please make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel and activate the bell to not miss out any of my new videos or live, to always try to improve and make your learning perfect. That's it for today. Thank you everyone for being here. It was an amazing and interesting listen and class tonight. Thank you everyone, and see you very soon. It was your French teacher, Marcel. Wherever you are, this is your channel. Be here, subscribe, and be tuned, and stay connected with EFM, Easy French with Marcel. Thank you, everyone. Alors, comme je disais, c'était votre professeur Marcel. Et donc, notre sujet du jour était comment améliorer son niveau de communication en français. Alors, comme je disais, j'ai fait le cours en anglais pour expliquer à mes étudiants qui parlent déjà l'anglais et donc qui apprennent le français. Alors, c'était pour eux. Maintenant, pour vous qui comprenez déjà le français, c'est aussi, je peux aussi vous transmettre ce que j'ai dit tout à l'heure, expliquer encore, pour que peut-être ça pourrait vous aider, vous qui voulez apprendre l'anglais, ces différentes méthodes ou solutions pourraient peut-être vous aider également à mieux apprendre, à mieux améliorer votre niveau d'anglais. Alors, il s'agissait de comment améliorer son niveau de communication en français, comment parler bien le français. Alors, comme toute langue, il faut d'abord un commencement. Alors, si vous avez déjà un début, un atout, des mots, et vous pouvez déjà démarrer, commencer à parler, c'est déjà très bien. Alors, comment il faut améliorer? Ça veut dire que déjà vous connaissez, vous avez déjà une connaissance déjà acquise. Alors, comment améliorer ces connaissances? Il faut d'abord savoir quelles sont mes lacunes en ces différentes connaissances pour mieux les améliorer. Alors, si je ne peux pas bien parler l'anglais, alors qu'est-ce qui m'empêche à mieux parler, à communiquer avec quelqu'un, à échanger avec quelqu'un qui parle déjà l'anglais? Alors, si je peux pas, j'arrive à comprendre l'anglais, mais je ne peux pas participer à la conversation ou à la communication ou à l'échange, alors ça veut dire que je n'ai pas de mots de vocabulaire. Alors, mon vocabulaire est beaucoup pauvre et j'ai moins de mots pour y participer à une conversation. Alors, ça veut dire que je dois enrichir mon vocabulaire avec plusieurs mots, plusieurs expressions, alors afin que je puisse participer à toutes sortes de débats, à toutes sortes de thèmes, à toutes sortes de sujets. Alors, vous devrez travailler sur comment avoir plus de mots dans plusieurs sujets. Alors, s'il s'agit du journalisme, du tourisme, du voyage, des découvertes, l'éducation, de votre travail, alors il faut avoir beaucoup de mots pour pouvoir parler déjà en anglais avec tous ces mots. Donc, il faut d'abord identifier quelles sont vos lacunes. Donc, si vous aviez lacunes comme moins de vocabulaire, alors il faut améliorer, avoir plus de mots, vocabulaire, plusieurs mots, plusieurs expressions. Et également avoir, si vous avez des lacunes comme la grammaire, alors ça veut dire qu'il faut maintenant travailler sur la grammaire en anglais, savoir comment se fait les accords, comment se fait le pluriel, comment se faire beaucoup de choses, le genre, beaucoup d'accords pour une grammaire, comment se pose des questions, comment se fait les échanges et tout ça. Alors, il faut maîtriser tous ces petits détails, ces petits détails, et donc qui pourront vous aider. Alors également, il y a aussi le point sur la prononciation. La prononciation qui est souvent certains, parce qu'ils comprennent déjà le français, alors ont l'habitude de dire des mots en français, c'est-à-dire en anglais, mais qu'ils le disent en français. Parce qu'ils n'ont pas la bonne prononciation en anglais, donc souvent, ils ont l'habitude de dire ces mots ou d'utiliser ces mots, de prononcer ces mots en français, qui est peut-être autre chose en anglais. Donc, souvent, nous tous, on le sait, nous avons beaucoup de mots dont nous connaissons en français, qui est aussi utilisé en anglais, qui est aussi utilisé en anglais comme en français. Mais la prononciation est différente. On a beaucoup de mots ou d'expressions similaires qui se ressemblent, qui s'écrivent de la même manière, mais qui ne se disent pas de la même manière, qui ne se lisent pas de la même manière, qui ne se prononcent pas de la même manière. Et donc, il faut faire la différence, comment le prononcer, comment les prononcer en anglais, comment les prononcer en français. Et donc, c'est un peu ça. Et donc, j'ai dit, pour la prononciation, si ça ne marche pas, si comment il faut améliorer, il faut regarder des films, des gens qui parlent déjà l'anglais, des films en anglais. Il faut écouter des musiques en anglais, des sons en anglais qui sont très bien, qui peuvent vous aider à mieux à entendre les sons ou la prononciation en anglais, qui pourra bien sûr vous aider à mieux à améliorer votre prononciation. Également, regarder des films, écouter la musique. Et si quand vous écoutez la musique, vous entendez des sons ou des trucs, vous n'arrivez pas à toujours assimiler, à mieux prononcer, alors il faut prendre les lyriques, c'est-à-dire le mot. Alors, la traduction, voilà, la traduction, les lyrics, c'est-à-dire il faut lire et comprendre en même temps qu'on écoute, il faut avoir les lyrics avec toi, avec soi, et puis comprendre les mots dont dit l'artiste ou le chanteur dans la chanson pour mieux apprécier et comprendre ce mot et avoir la bonne prononciation et le bon son. Alors, c'est un peu ça, quelques détails dont j'ai donné tout à l'heure en France, en anglais, à mes étudiants qui apprennent le français. Et donc, j'espère que ça a été fructueux et bénéfique pour tout un chacun, ceux qui apprennent le français ainsi que ceux qui apprennent l'anglais. Merci à tous. Et donc, c'était avec un immense plaisir d'être en votre compagnie pour ce direct et pour ce cours qui est comment améliorer son français, pardon, ou son anglais. Voilà, donc son niveau de communication en français ou son niveau de communication en anglais. Donc, c'était un peu ça avec votre professeur Marcel. Si vous êtes nouveau sur ce direct avec Monsieur Marcel, soyez sûrs et rassurez-vous que vous êtes connecté et abonné. N'oubliez pas de vous abonner à ma chaîne YouTube, à mon compte Instagram et à mon compte Facebook qui est aussi là où je donne des cours. Et donc, vous êtes tous bienvenus. Alors, c'était moi, c'était avec un plaisir. Et donc, merci à tous et à toutes et à très bientôt. C'était votre professeur Marcel. On se voit pour un nouveau numéro, pour un nouveau direct et pour un nouveau sujet. C'était un plaisir. Au revoir. Bye everyone and see you on our next live. À très bientôt. Merci.